Well, hello there, fellow traders, once again. This is Dave the Trader, and we're taking a look at the Analyze tab on the ThinkorSwim platform. And in this segment, I want to talk to you about price slices, how to use them, what they are, and how they can be useful. These three lines right here, these yellow dashed lines, are called price slices. And they're controlled by this, by the controls in this little drawer here, labeled, obviously enough, price slices. And in this section, you see three price slices. Each one of these rows corresponds to one of the slices up here in the graph. So this slice at 1922.25 is this slice right here. This slice at 1747.50 is in the middle, and 1572.75 is on the left. So the first column is the stock price, and if you wish, you can increment it. And when you do change the stock price to set the particular stock price, to set the slice exactly where you want it on this scale, we could set it to, for example, 2000, and it would go to 2045 cents. This right here determines whether or not that price slice is going to move with the price of the stock as the price of the stock changes during the market hours or not. If it's locked, it's not going to move. So you could set this to exactly 2000. And no matter what happens with the stock price in the market, this number, this price slice, will not move. If you want it to move with the price of the stock, then you can unlock it, and it will move up and down with the underlying price. Then there's offset. Notice when I lock the slice, the offset disappears, because this is the whole story. What this number is where the slice is. When I unlock it, now things get a little bit more interesting. So you're going to float with the price of the stock. But you see this percentage here and this plus 10%? So this slice is going to be set and kept at 10% higher than the stock price. I can manipulate this percentage. Take it up to 15%, for example. And notice how as I change it, bring it back down to 10, that slice moves up and down. The other possibilities here, instead of a percentage, is sigma, which is standard deviation. So I can set it to 1 standard deviation, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, and so on. So let's set it to, say, 1 standard deviation. Spoiler alert, that line just happens to be lined up with that shaded portion. We'll talk more about that later and learn more about what these percentages up here are. In the meantime, you can set this quickly to, for example, half a standard deviation. And the standard deviation comes from the underlying's volatility. So it's going to look at the volatility of this underlying, determine what the standard deviation is from that, and that's where these lines will then appear. So you could, for example, something which is fairly common, go 1 standard deviation up and 1 standard deviation down. Whoops. We'll have to click on this, left click on this, and it cycles around to all the different possible settings. If you leave it on standard deviation or look sigma, then you can set this to minus 1 sigma or 1 standard deviation. Other possibilities are EPR. EPR is the expected price range. And TD Ameritrade looks at EPR Let's see where it is. If we go one EPR up and one EPR in the negative direction, oops, set it to EPR there. There we go. You can see the EPR is quite a ways from the stock price. So if you look this up in TD Ameritrade's documentation, it says, quote, expected price range, or EPR, represents the firm's best current estimate of the price change of a given security over a one-day period. So what that says is that this distance is its best current estimate of the price change for a given security for today. That would be crazy. Turns out this number is used in the calculation of portfolio margin and used to make margin calls and to alert TD Ameritrade to accounts that are needing more money, basically. So it's basically the TD Ameritrade's calculation. But that's what that is, expected price range, and I have not found a use for that, just so you know. But I have had for this. This is simply a dollar amount above and below the current price. Then I can set this to, for example, plus $5. Well, when you're talking about a stock as expensive as Amazon's, this is really not going to mean much unless you want to go $100 high, $100 low. Let's set that to dollar. There we go. There, $100 low, $100 high. That's about one standard deviation. Close, isn't it? All right. So those are the possible things that you can set this to have it float with the price of the stock. Dollar, percent, sigma, EPR. Those are the four possibilities for to set a slice's relationship with the current price. And for each of those, it puts up what it hopes is convenient values on this menu right here that you can just set them to. So let's take a look at the columns. This is showing you the values for these, the value for this curve at all of these different values. So for example, this slice right here at 5.73% above the current price, it's showing you that the delta at that point today on the magenta line is minus 10.43, or minus $10.43. That's the value of delta for that slice. The value of gamma is minus 0.09. The value of theta is 9.26. The value of vega, 36.28, and so on. Okay, this column is the profit and loss from the open of this position. Another way of saying that is that it's this point. So for this slice, 291.98, that is this point on the line right there. It has dropped $65.52 today. That point on the curve has dropped that far. And if the price were at that point today of the slice, then this would be the resulting value for the buying power effect. Right now, we're reserving $4,000 in the account to hold this position. This number right here, $291.97, that is the current value of this trade. If I were to take it off, I would make that much money today. Does that make sense? Okay, good. Now let's take a quick look at the slice menu here. One possibility is to there's a whole range of predefined configurations for the slices. Everything from the default, which is minus 10%, the base, and plus 10%. I guess the base is the current price of the stock. Notice the locks are set appropriately to float with the stock up and down. You know, let's take a look at another position. There we go. This is a position in PG. Note that each underlying will have its own settings for the slices, and it'll remember them so that you can set up the slices for a particular trade. Let's say the current price and the break-even price. And we'll take this slice and delete it. We can delete it just like that. Now there are only two slices. One at 118, locked to $118.31, which is about the break-even for this trade. And the other is floating with the stock price plus $0. In other words, the stock price itself. So I can take a look right here and see that the relationship between the current stock price and the break-even stock price is a relationship that I like. And the total profit on this trade would be $449 if I took it off today. Set slices. Let's see. There's seven rows with a 5% step. That's a lot of slices, but you can really look at what the, for example, what the delta effect is going to be at each of these steps in the price. Then there's 11 rows. That's a lot. A lot of slices. One setting that I do use quite often is break even. When you choose break even, up comes a submenu. You can say, here's the break even today for the magenta line. That's the break even for today. The break even at expiration, which is the 3rd of January, 2020. The break even on that date would be the day after. This date should be set to one day after expiration, because it's the midnight value. The time is actually midnight on the next day. So the break-even at expiration is $118.28. The last couple of things on this price slices menu to show you are slices to charts, reorder, and reset. Reset slices resets the slices to the default, which is this setup of slices. Plus 10%, minus 10%, and the current stock price, floating with the stock price. I have never found this to be useful, but maybe that's just me. Let's look at a more interesting trade before I show you that last option. Go back to our Amazon trade, and let's talk about break-evens over the course of the trade. Let's set slices to the break-even at expiration. And now we'll take this, we'll get this menu and say set slices to charts. And we'll just do one chart. And there you have it. When you look at this chart now, it has the top and bottom break-even points of that trade. So you can easily glance at this chart and see just where you're, just how your trade is doing relative to the position that you want to be in. Back to Amazon, of course, if you would ever like to get back to that slice default, maybe it's useful for you. You can click on this menu and say reset slices, and boom, you have the default slice configuration right there at your fingertips. This plus, of course, is if you want to add if you want to add new slices, and then set them to, well, whatever you'd like to set them to. And then you can come back. Oh yeah. Let's reorder slices by price, which resorts this list right here so that it looks more intuitive of an ordering based on your slice layout. And that's it, fellow traders, for slices. Next, I want to direct your attention to these percentages up here. These mysterious looking percentages, they have to do with the odds and probabilities of the stock price being within a certain range or outside of a certain range, depending on the settings. The probability section of the Analyze tab lecture is next.